Like duty, delta and base period, we have another important technical terms with us. These technical terms are used in irrigation field or in water resource engineering field. So let's discuss about this. First is core period. So core period is nothing but we had discussed the base period in previous slide. Base period means what? The period in which the first watering from the preparation of the land up to the last watering before the harvesting. This period is known as a core period. It is known as a base period. So the distribution of water during this period is not uniform. So crop require maximum water during the first watering after the crops have grown few centimeters. So during the subsequent watering, the quantity of water needed by the crop gradually decreases and is released when crop gains maturity. So period, the portion of the base period in which the watering, core watering, initial watering is needed is known as a core period. So we can define this core period as in which the initial watering is needed. It is known as a core period. Next is a core depth. Like our delta. Delta means the total depth of water which has to be sustained above the surface without any losses. So depth of the water which is supplied to the land for the cultivation process is known as a core depth. And core watering is nothing but the initial watering which is supplied to the crop is known as a core watering. So other than this, we have a crop period. So like a base period, core period, these two periods, these both periods are related to the watering system. But crop period is the period from the instant of a sowing up to the harvesting of the crop. So it is the whole period of a crop which required or which is from sowing up to the harvesting time. The rotation period, it is the period between the two consecutive watering. The crop does not require the continuous supply of water. The consecutive watering is given to the crop. These two, the period in between the two consecutive watering, it is known as a rotation period. It is also known as a frequency of a irrigation. Now the outlet discharge factor, the duty at the outlet of the canal is known as a outlet discharge factor. Duty varies from place to place. It is a maximum on the agricultural field, but it is a minimum at the head of the canal. So duty at the outlet of the canal is known as an outlet discharge factor. The time factor is the ratio of number of days of actual canal run to the number of irrigation period is known as a time factor. Capacity factor means what? It is the ratio of the mean supply to the full supply of the canal is known as a capacity factor. So by calculating this capacity factor, we can easily find out the average supply. We can easily find out the design discharge of the canal. So the time factor and the capacity factor are the two important terms which are used for solving the numericals. So this might be asked in university exam also. After capacity factor, we have a cumec day. We know that cumec is nothing but a meter cube per second of water, or the volume of a water which is flowing, which is discharging at the time or at the rate of a time in the terms of a second. So the quantity of a water flowing for one day at a rate of 1 meter cube per second is known as a cumec day. Now the full supply coefficient. The coefficient means what? it is the ratio, the area which is irrigated or area estimated to be irrigated during the best period of the crop divided by the design full supply discharge of the canal at its head during the maximum demand. The crop ratio depends upon the crop pattern or crop type on the crop season. So the crop ratio, it is nothing but the ratio of area irrigated in a rabi season to the area irrigated in a kharif season. The ratio is known as a crop ratio. We have overlap allowances. See, it may happen sometimes that the crop of some season may overlap some period of a next crop season. For example, if we are taking the production of a kharif crop as well as we are taking the production of a perennial crop also. So kharif crop's sowing time is from June and its harvesting time is in October. So likewise, our perennial crops also require the water in October season because perennial crops require water throughout the year. So it may overlap with the other crop or other season of a crop. So when such overlapping takes place, the crops of both the season require water simultaneously. Thus, the overlap allowance is the extra discharge which is required for this purpose. Extra discharge which is required to take the production of the another season of a crop also is known as a overlap allowances. Now the main and important term is gross commanded area. It is the area, or this area is divided into a number of drainage boundaries as well as the number of watersheds. It includes all the area, all the watershed boundaries. So it is the total area lying between the drainage boundaries which can be commanded or irrigated by canal system. So the area on which the by supplying the irrigation water, we can take the production or we can cultivate this land properly. So this is known as a cross commanded area. Again, this cross commanded area divided into two categories, that is a culturable commanded area and unculturable commanded area. Culturable commanded area, the area on which crops can be grown satisfactorily is known as the culturable commanded area. Means the soil is a fertile one, or there is no other boundaries on such an area, so that we can use this area totally for the agricultural purpose. In the opposite side, the unculturable commanded area means the remaining area which contains alkaline soil, infertile barren land, village local ponds. It is when it is obstructed by the number of things and number of structures, or sometimes the soil is infertile one, we cannot take the production of the crop on such area. This area is known as a unculturable commanded area. Again, the culturable commanded area divided into two categories. We are discussing these two types also. But before this, let's discuss about the intensity of irrigation. Intensity of irrigation is expressed in a percentage, and it is nothing but a culturable commanded area proposed to be irrigated during a crop season or during a year. This is known as a intensity of irrigation. It is the culturable commanded area that has to be proposed to irrigated during a crop season. We have a crop season, kharif season, rabi season, summer season, perennial season. So according to this, the culturable commanded area that has been proposed to be irrigated, the percentage is known as the percentage that has been determined is known as the intensity of irrigation. Then one of the term which is used is paleo. Paleo means the first watering which is given to the land before sowing of the crop, which is also required for the cultivation purpose, which is also required for the plugging purpose. Then here the culturable cultivated area. This culturable commanded area divided into two categories, that is the culturable cultivated area. The culturable cultivated area means the area on which the crop is grown at a particular time or particular season. So it is known as a culturable cultivated area. Again, we have a culturable uncultivated area. It is that area on which crop is not sown in a particular season. So according to the season, according to the crop type, we have that much important terms that might be used in an irrigation field or a water resource engineering field. And these terms are also used for solving the numericals also. So in next video, we are looking for the numericals, various types of a numerical, how this type of a numericals will be solved. So thank you.